homework or something. I don't know. Either way, we've got a set in front of us. We can't talk much more about anime because, well, we've got an anime battle here. We've got NorCal versus SoCal for the opportunity to take on Ned in Losers Finals.
One of the oldest rivalries, dates back to the beginning of time. SoCal and NorCal.
It's almost as bad as North Carolina versus South Carolina.
Is that actually a thing?
No, I just made it up.
Okay. Okay, but this is what I was talking about. With the way that T3 Dom will set up his ledge guard, it makes it so difficult. And he's, once again, going to just slowly adjust the timings. Almost like a guitar player who quickly, like, or not quickly, but slowly ramps up the rhythm of that he's playing in. We're going to see T3 Dom do it to Kurama to the point where he actually becomes uncomfortable with the options that he's forced to pick.
Yeah, so one of the, I've talked about this in coaching before. One of the biggest things that a lot of Smash players are uncomfortable with is tempo control. Being able to control exactly when confrontations happen, where confrontations happen, and how quickly they take place. And T3 Dom is one of the absolute best in the entire world at controlling the tempo of a match. And speaking of control, gets that perfectly placed axe to kill Kurama on the first stock.
That's right. And now we're starting the dismantle come into play. I mean, only 43% onto T3 Dom. These fireballs that we usually see Kurama approaching with, guess what? They're going to be nullified by either the whip or one of the many projectiles that we see T3 Dom using.
Although here's going to be an up air ladder, he gets a little bit of percent, but it doesn't matter. He's still caught by Holy Fire and the up B out of shield from T3 Dom. I love T3 Dom's option coverage. We keep saying like T3 Dom is one of the best at X. He's really good at tempo control. He's really good at option coverage, and he's really good at beating up Kurama.
Oh man, making Kurama like, it's working so difficult for Kurama because just as soon as he gets back on stage, T3 Dom just whips him out. Pushes him right back off.
Literally no time to breathe. Every single moment of every single interaction is just T3 Dom sending stuff flying at him. But finally, Kurama manages to get that F smash chase to take off the first stock. But there's no rest for the weary. There's no rest for the wicked as he gets his stock taken right back.
I mean, that's even comes down to game knowledge. T3 Dom knew that with the placement of the holy water, Kurama at a high percent, not gonna have that much time of invulnerability on the ledge. Okay, there you go. There's all of you. Didn't get to see the up air conversion, but you know what? I'm pretty sure we're gonna see that setup more than once, so maybe he'll get it next time.
It's one of the classics for the Belmonts. This time, though, he's going to try for the Holy Cross setup, but not able to find it. Tries for the up air instead. Kurama actually trying to play back a little bit more. And I know it's an odd prospect to see a Mario try and play back against the Belmont, but he's really got to do it because Dom has been so oppressive in the neutral this time. Gets the up air, still can't even continue it into a combo.
Yeah, it's really about the patience, especially when you start seeing Dom get a little bit aggressive. But there you go. There's take him for a ride, Kurama.
Gets that stock there, but it's still a tall task. It's more than possible, but it's going to be really, really difficult, especially with Kurama at kill percent right now.
Oh.
But this very well might be it.
Is he at
this
kill
very
percent?
Well might be it because he's going to get the up air into the fair. The funny forward aerial to take out the first game ripped it away from T3 Dom.
I mean, he's named Kurama. Kurama is a very methodical character. You can see him really taking his time and looking for the opportunities from where he can push his advantage. And push his advantage, he did.
Dude, I'm gonna lose my voice screaming at all these sets because we've had so much fun already and so much fun to be had. We're gonna be getting into game number two.
Yet.
We're nowhere close to done, not even with this set, because we're going right back to Smashville. We'll see if Dom can continue what he was doing earlier with the complete total dominance, or if Kurama has flicked the switch and this is now his set.
Okay, well, here you go. T3 Dom, of course, setting up center stage. Kurama fighting his way, trying to look for his opportunity to get in, dashing it with a shield, only to get knocked right back out with T3 Dom's down tilt.
Well, tries to get the up air and does find it off of the up tilt. Dom, though, immediately gets the double holy fire. I've never seen that before, actually.
Okay, even course, the boomerang coming back with all of you. Kurama answering right back with a couple of up airs of his own. Forced to use, oh, is that too far? That's too far!
Way too far off stage and can't make it back. Kurama looks like he did indeed flick that switch. He's got Dom figured out. Takes the first stock.
Oh, here we go. trying to get the back air, throwing out the axes, forcing the air dodge, and yeah, just getting clipped by the holy water. That's going to be an S smash, a free S smash from T3 Dom, evening up the stock. But an invulnerability, you can see Kurama taking advantage. And here we go, not again, not again!
Yes, again, Z-Fly. Kurama, that's his bread and butter, and he's going to put it all over T3 Dom's toast.
Oh, man. Well, I don't know if T3 Dom wants that kind of jam, but guess what? He's got no choice. Kurama is definitely in the driver's seat.
I think this is a bed and breakfast. T3 Dom with the back air out of shield, keeping Kurama at least on the back foot. With a full stock lead, Kurama doesn't really need much to close this out.
It really just one rising up air. That rising up air has gotten Kurama so many stocks against T3 Dom. Not only against T3 Dom, but I'm sure throughout this entire night.
I bet you Kurama has killed more people with up air fair. I don't know, than there are like fish in the ocean. Somewhere where there's a lot of something.
Very true. There's more up air forward airs than there are
stars in
sand
the sky.
Sand in Egypt.
There are people cheering for Kurama at MSM.
Definitely that.
Yeah.
I can hear people still cheering for Dom, even though you know, they need to make some noise for their boy. They need to power him up a little bit. They were getting real loud earlier.
They were getting incredibly loud when Dom was taking on and taking down Fatality. But some of that energy's kind of been lost. They're missing it a little bit now that Kurama's turning it up and putting the hurt on him. Gonna try and run it to PS2 to make something different happen here. I just noticed, sorry, that Dom's in-game tag is just press B.
Oh yeah, I actually don't know the story behind it, but I always
assume... Because he plays Belmont, I'm guessing.
Yeah. It's because he plays Belmont. But honestly, if you like look at the way that T3 Dom plays, he uses the C-stick a lot more than he pushes B.
Those C-stick aerials are coming out in full force. We're just seeing all those fares and bears right now, demonstrating your point beautifully.
Yeah, okay, but take this. Just telling Kurama to push him back one, little by little. Good parry, and of course we're going to see the B out of shield. We're seeing a much more dominant Kurama, or a much more dominant T3 Dom here in game three.
Back air. But I mean, we saw much more dominant T3 Dom in game number one as well, and we saw exactly how that went. Kurama, he just needs one opening, and he can make T3 Dom's life absolute pain. But speaking of pain, the whip runs across his face then and there, takes the first stock without a hit.
Yeah,
long form zero to death. It was almost a full minute.
It was almost a full minute, but he did in fact close out the zero to death. I'm curious what if T3 Dom is in fact able to take this game three, it's gonna be Kurama's counterpick from here on out.
In any other
this
situation,
this is gonna be the first time that we actually see the game flow in this. Like this, in this direction.
Oh, but Kurama tries for the up air, does not manage to get the full combo, but 68%, nothing to sneeze at on T3 Dom. We try and chase him down, but the up airs are going to keep him in check. T3 Dom not letting him touch down on the ground.
Yeah, you get one up tilt, you get one up air. That is when you start DIing as if you are about to lose your stock, because guess what? You might.
You very well might. I thought T3 Dom was going to go for that chase up high with the upbeat. Didn't quite pull the trigger on it. And oh, the jab almost, it is going to save Kurama from the pain of holy fire.
Yeah, honestly, the way that it bounced off Kurama too, it actually put T3 Dom in danger as well, because once if it doesn't land on the ground from T3 Dom throwing it, from Richter throwing it, it actually can hurt. It can hurt Richter as well. So there you go, a lot of shield pressure and just dropping shield a little bit too early. Kurama losing another stock. T3 Dom still on three.
Trying to get this stock here, gets the back air, sends T3 Dom off into the corner. The back throw here is going to set Kurama up for an edge guard, but well, the whip, the tether, just lets him get back, hang down, swing low.
Yeah, Kurama actually went off stage with a falling nair. Very long-lasting hitbox, trying to actually clip T3 Dom on the way back. Let's see if Kurama's going to try and go for it again, but no, we see the immediate latch and an up smash to punish.
So, Kurama takes the first stock, and we've seen exactly how he can take stocks in a moment's notice with just a single up air setup. Gets the up air here, but it's too far from the side.
Uh-oh,
going to get the chain here.
Here
four,
we go.
Four, five, six, into the down air, sends Dom straight up. He tried for that same cross up that he got on Ned earlier.
Oh, you
and there
me?
It is. I spoke it into existence, the fair at the ledge. Kurama looking for the first 3-0 we've seen in top eight.
Yeah, but T3 Dom still got a fighting chance. Honestly, as long as he sticks away from these ledges, I think he's good. Here you go, SoCal.
Oh, no.
Popping off
no.
for their boy, trying to power him up. Here he goes. More up airs.
Oh, no.
More up airs. He's
oh,
not
no.
at the ledge, though.
But he's going to die anyway. No, he's not. Tries so hard for the down air to finish it.
There
and
we
T3
go.
Dom.
There we go. T3 Dom on the board. Give him the up smash. Give him all the way up.
You can see it in the crowd. People are popping off. The T3 Dom chants were going wild. They want their boy. They want SoCal in losers finals. But Karama, well, he's not going to make it easy.
Karama definitely not going to make it easy. Of course, you know, we already saw him pushing his own tempo in game three, making his comeback very similar to game one. Almost got it. But just one mistake is what allowed T3 Dom to make it back to stage, giving him another second chance at life, and allowed him to win game three.
Running it right back to PS2 as well, Karama probably believes that, you know, he very nearly stole that game away from Dom, so given a little bit more time on the stage, he can definitely make it happen, and this has been a fantastic start. He's looking for the up airs, but Dom gets a dare of his own.
Okay, yeah, Karama was definitely, he knew that he had Dom in a horrible position, and he was waiting for Dom to actually use the air dodge, but Dom, being the aggressive player he is, no air dodges. I don't even know if he has the R button behind.
Screw air dodges, I'm going to do a move instead. I push this button now.
Yeah, I'm convinced that he doesn't have the R button bind.
I don't see him grab too much either, honestly.
he grabs every once in a while, but it's when it'll be like really near at the ledge and probably at a higher percent. Oh, there it is.
There it is. Yep. Dom just wants to make me look foolish. I'm never going to forgive him for this, and I don't know if Karama will ever forgive him for this ledge trap, though he does get back up on.
Yeah, an uppy out of shield, just not allowing Karama to breathe. Good positioning from Karama, though, not...
Oh!
Wow, okay.
The snipe?
Yes, that is the T3 Dom throwing out so many projectiles, you essentially lose track.
I mean, I'm certainly losing track, and I'm just commentating. I don't even have to focus on my own character here. I know it would be absolutely insanely difficult to keep track of all of that playing against him, but Karama doing it right here, right now, keeps him stuck at the ledge, tries for the up air fair, tries for the F smash too.
No up smash from Karama? That should have been the freest up smash. May not have killed because Richter is so heavy, but it definitely would have given him stage control.
Might have been a misinput. Either way, it's going to be a mistake, that's for sure.
Hey, fighting back Karama. I mean, we've seen it. How many times have we seen Karama just flip the switch, turn the tables, and just take games? There you go. There's the bounce. Get the alley-oop.
He doesn't want losers finals unless it's a reverse three stock. He's got to go in, gets his confidence up before fighting Ned again. Get in style.
True, but guess what? T3 Dom, he wants his spot. He wants his opportunity at Cosmos. Okay, bad DI from T3 Dom, but still being a little too heavy for it to actually kill.
Richter is definitely on the heavier side for Smash characters, so going to be living this quite some time. And keep in mind, Karama down a stock right now, needs this stock soon and a little bit more to boot.
Ooh, okay, I like the down air. Even though it got parried, it still, you know, puts Dom in like that aerial spin position, allowing him to escape. Very nice, Dom. Karama still on the hunt though. You can see all these back airs really only needs one to land, especially if it's near the ledge.
Popped all the way up though and chases with the fireball back air. Dom, nothing he could have done there because he was stuck in the hit stun from fireball. Really well played from Karama.
Yeah. Of course, here you go. Karama on the hunt again, landing a down air, trying to already fish for those up airs. Karama. Karama, Karama, Karama.
Well, Karama, 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 down one stock left. I feel like we're trying to summon his comeback like Beetlejuice.
Oh, if only it was that easy, right? Okay.
Gets the parry.
Yep, T3 Dom, up B out of shield. Great tool for Richter. But this
oh,
is
no.
it. This is what we've seen over and over again. The up B, and yep, taking his money, taking his life.
Scream of agony coming out from Richter Belmont there. We've all been hit by the Mario ladder. It hurts, we know.
Oh, the Nair into, drag Nair into the up B. Just, okay, you know what, Dom? It might be time just to press B. It might be time to do that.
Just press B.
Just it's press B.
He put it in his tag to remind himself.
I mean, that's a very smart tool, actually. It's like self-coaching.
Isn't coaching banned? Are we gonna have to DQ Dom?
Not when you coach yourself.
Okay.
I think it's fine.
Karama making it back to stage, getting through the holy fire, but not through the whip. And he, well, this ledge trap could be what decides we go to game five.
And here we go, rinse and repeat. Just these holy fires, F tilts. You're gonna jump up back there. There we go. Yo! This is game five. Game five. T3 Dom, Karama.
We have it. Exactly what we wanted. Game one, the reverse three stock was dominant from Karama. Game two, the entire game was dominant from Karama. Game three, well, Dom, he just turned it on. He's here. He's looking to play against Ned in Losers Finals. And, well, he's got himself the opportunity as Karama takes us to PS2 one last time.
Oh, man, that's got to be so nerve-wracking for T3 Dom, because this is where he had those two L's against Karama.
Yeah, I mean, it's a really, really, really scary prospect, but both of them seem to have confidence in this pick. They've been running it back for so long, and already off the bat, Dom swinging for the fences.
And here we go. I mean, this is a very aggressive start for Karama, already able to weave around the traps that Dom has been setting up, throwing out so many hitboxes.
Gonna get the down throw though into the up airs and the wrong hitbox. Sour spot on the fair going to mean Dom gets a second lease on life. Might have to pay the mortgage soon though as Karama tries again and yet another sour spot.
Okay, and I like that, the drift back, just avoiding the back air, avoiding all of Karama's aggression and even pressuring him, trapping him on the platform. And here we go, it is ledge trap time, but wow, Karama escapes the first try.
Gets away from it, and we saw it at the end of the last game that Karama getting past Dom's ledge trap, or really anyone getting past Dom's ledge trap, is no small feat, but I think for the first time in a while, this is Karama like in the lead at the start of the game.
Yeah, I think we only really saw that in game two.
I think even in game two, Dom took the first stock, if I'm not mistaken.
Okay, all right.
Playing a little bit of jump rope there with the Holy Cross, though, to get over top of it.
Yeah, T3 Dom does such an amazing job of actually keeping track of where that Holy Cross is. No matter what direction he sends, he knows exactly when he's going to come back.
He didn't have a jump.
No jump?
I'm pretty sure T3 Dom's bear stole Karama's jump, and Karama didn't even realize it.
Okay, well, that is the lead that T3 Dom is going to want to have. Not exactly going to be a cushion because he's already at 153%. We can see down air. We can see up smash. We can see back air. Back throw? Not yet.
All of SoCal's behind T3 Dom right now. We hear their calls, we hear their cheers, and he's absolutely also hearing them himself. Oh. But Karama, with the world stacked against him, gets that down air, gets that kill, and we are so, so close to even.
It's true, okay, but there's the nair. We've seen so many combos and high damaging combos, especially from Karama landing with, starting with nair and the up air. Here we go. This is the damaging combo. Extending it with up tilt. Very nice.
Is he dead? No. T3 Dom with some fantastic DI is going to be able to live it. Gets back to stage with the upbeat. But Karama making it very, very costly. 89% off of that one conversion.
And with only 31% onto Karama, you know T3 Dom's going to have to put in the work. Yes, he can rack it up slowly with his traps over and over, but guess what? It only really takes one time for Karama to enter into T3 Dom's danger zone to really lose his stock. But here we go,
Speaking
going off
the stage. Danger zone. There it is! He misses the down smash! Goes for it! The second time's the charm because T3 Dom has brought Karama to his tournament stock, his last chance at the LCQ. T3 Dom
and
shatter his dreams.
The one more stock chance start coming out. That's gotta be so nerve-wracking. I don't care who you are, no one really gets over tournament nerves. And the one more stock chance can break a player, but okay, the chance go away. Karama maintained his composure. And now, can he take this stock to even it up to one stock apiece in game five? And
yes,
the up smash from the roll gets it last.
Karama gets the up smash on the roll get up. A fantastic read from him, and it's going to bring us to the last stock, game five. This is for all the marbles, and T3 Dom, well, his up B misses. He tries to get back up onto the stage, but it's not going to work because Karama keeps pushing the issue, but no fair. He's not able to do it.
He's going to
try again.
Karama is still on the hunt, maintaining these grabs, getting the up airs, but here we are. The holy water connects, and now T3 Dom in the driver's seat.
Oh,
never mind.
No.
Take it right back.
Oh,
Karama with the up B whips. And down air, to make it back to the ledge, make it back to the stage just that much quicker.
T3 Dom breathing a sigh of relief. What a good last second jump to escape from what was certain death at the hands of Karama. Now has a second chance, a second try, but the back throw going to put him off stage really far. The first tether misses, but the second one gets him where he needs to go.
Okay.
On stage, the back air comes out, and Karama looking to end his run here with the ledge trap and the up smash. Karama going to Losers Finals, where he'll face off against Ned.
What a fantastic run from T3 Dom and Karama.